Hey everyone, Scott here. I've been successfully selling private label on Amazon since 2015, and I'm excited about this video because I truly think it's gonna help you make better Amazon listings or improve the ones you already have. And really, even if you don't sell on Amazon, but are involved in other types of e-commerce like drop shipping, this will still be beneficial since the same principles can be applied to your product pages. OpenAI's ChatGPT has been all the rage recently, getting over a million users in under a week. You might have even used it already yourself. ChatGPT is a tool driven by artificial intelligence that behaves like a chatbot. You can ask it questions like, how many sellers are on Amazon? Or give it commands like, write a short poem that rhymes about Jeff Bezos. So I thought it'd be fun to see if I can write an Amazon listing using ChatGPT, maybe the title, bullet points, and product description. If you enjoyed this, please don't forget to put a like on the video and subscribe. I truly appreciate you taking the time to do that, and let's get right into it. So you can sign up for ChatGPT by going to openai.com and creating an account. If you already used this before, put down in the comments the best thing you've used it for, or maybe the funniest thing you've used it for. And if you can, put the prompt that you use to get those results so other people can try it out. So let's start with the Amazon title. And for this example, I'm going to be using the classic garlic press example. So let's try this out. I'm gonna tell it to write an Amazon product title for a garlic press and see what happens. All right, so there's the title it generated. Stainless steel garlic press, easy squeezed, minced garlic in seconds, dishwasher safe. Okay, so that title wasn't bad. I went ahead and created a prompt with a little more detail now to see if it's able to create a title using specific keywords that I want it to use. And you might see a little bit of jumping around here. I'm gonna cut some areas where I'm typing so you don't have to see me wait to see me type out all these different prompts. Let's go ahead and try this. I have write an Amazon product title for a garlic press, and I have used the keywords stainless steel, mince, crush, peel, and comfortable. Okay, so now I have comfortable stainless steel garlic press, mince, crush, and peel garlic with ease. All right, so I think that between those two, I actually have enough to work with. I think that you could take what this gives you and also look at your competitors, see what type of keywords they're using, and then come up with the best combination that you think will be good for your product. Of course, when you're doing Amazon SEO to optimize your listing, for keyword ranking, you wanna make sure you're looking up which keywords have the most search volume and which ones your customers are gonna be looking for so you know how to optimize your title properly. I think that this probably won't know exactly how to optimize your title because it doesn't know SEO, at least not yet, for Amazon. So it's best to kind of take what it gives as a suggestion. It might give you some ideas you didn't have before, but you really wanna make sure, especially with the title when it comes to Amazon products, is extremely important for how your product ranks on Amazon. So we'll go ahead and move on to the bullet points now. So these are the bullet points I came up with that I want each bullet point to go over. I have high quality stainless steel, easy to clean, variety of uses, mince, crush, and peel, comfortable handle, and sleek modern design. So I'm gonna try a few different prompts here to see what it comes up with. The first thing I'm gonna try is to turn each of these features into benefits. One of the best things you do with bullet points is a lot of people when they write bullet points, they talk about the features of the product. But what can make a big difference for the person that's actually doing the shopping and looking to decide if they wanna buy your product is if you get into the actual benefits of those features. So you have these features, they're good, okay. But then what does the customer actually get? What do they receive? What are the benefits that they get from those features? So let's see what it comes up with here. And let's go ahead and put this in. Okay, so these are the benefits that it came up with. So for a high quality stainless steel, it said that the durable construction and rust resistant materials ensures long lasting use. So really the key point there is that it ensures long lasting use. That would be the benefit of using stainless steel. Dishwasher safe for quick and easy cleaning. So it just shows you don't have to, you know, don't have to always hand wash it, just throw in a dishwasher and do it that way. That would be a benefit to save on time. You have here mince, crush, and peel garlic. So it's saving time and effort in the kitchen. So that'd be the benefit of being able to do those variety of uses is that it saves you time and saves you effort. You just need one tool to do all these different things. Yeah, a comfortable ergonomic handle helps reduce hand fatigues. That'd be a benefit there. Another thing to point out here is if you don't like what it comes up with, or maybe you just want to see some other options, you can always come down here and click on regenerate response. Okay, so it came up with some additional things here. You can always go through and try to regenerate it, see if it comes up, spits out something different. But let's go ahead and try something different here. So I have here instead now turn each of these points into bullet points. So let's see what it comes up instead. Okay, so these are the additional points that it came up with here. So I think that something I want to try here is to expand on these points that it's coming up with. Okay, so what I wanted to do is to take the bullet points that I originally had and some of the different features that it came up with. I wanted to expand on it, to add some more text to it. So I have expand on this, made from stainless steel, durable and long lasting, which just kind of combines these high quality stainless steel points and durable and long lasting. So let's see what it comes up for that. Okay, so that was actually quite a lot of text that it came up with there. So what I would do if I was using this to write bullet points, I'd be taking note of maybe certain sentences or phrasings that I think are good for my product. And then I would start piecing those together. So you just take the little individual sentences or phrases or just words that you like, and then start molding those together to come up with the best bullet point that you can. So let's try this next bullet point and see what it comes up for this. I'm gonna use the same command, expand on this, comfortable handle, ergonomic and easy to use. Okay, so that's what it came up with. So now I wanna try a couple different things because really what you get out of this depends on the different types of questions or prompts that you give it. So sometimes, might come with something good, might come with something bad, but you can really get creative with it and just try different things and see what you come up with. So one thing I wanna do is I want to see if this is very kind of straightforward, maybe a little bit boring text. So what I want to do is I want to have it rewrite it to be more creative, see if it can come with a more creative tone for it. So what I put is simply just rewrite this in a more creative way, and let's see what it does. Okay, so that's what it came up with. You could try some different things as well. Let's try something for fun. How about we'll have it rewrite it in a way that would convince someone to buy it. So let's go ahead and put that in. So what I put in here is rewrite this in a way that would convince someone to buy a garlic press. So let's see what that comes up with. See if it comes up with anything different or really just the same content. All right, so that's what it came up with. And honestly, I think it's an improvement from the last couple of things we've gotten. It's a little bit more geared towards a shopper that would be looking that can maybe compare some different garlic presses. I think this does a better job of selling it. Okay, so let's try one more thing for this bullet point here before we move on. And that is, I want to try rewriting this to make it shorter because this is a relatively long bullet point for Amazon. You don't want to have giant long text. There is a limit to how many characters you can have. So let's go ahead and see if they can rewrite it to make it shorter and not as long. So I just have in here, rewrite this to make it shorter, and I'll just use this and here we go. And there's what it came up with. It took, all these sentences here and condensed it down into about 1, 2, 3 sentences. And honestly, I think that's pretty good. So the key thing here would be just to go through, try a lot of different ideas. If you come up with an idea, throw it in there and see what it comes up with, because it might be something really interesting. And you just go ahead and repeat the process for each of the bullet points you were trying to do. So let's move on to the product description now. So what I have in here is write a product description for a stainless steel garlic press. Let's see what it comes up with. Okay, so that's what it came up with. And one thing to keep in mind as well is that it does remember some of the previous things you put in there. So sometimes it will start pulling from previous bullet points or previous prompts you put in there. At least that's kind of what I noticed. So if you want to start fresh, if you notice it's kind of repeating things too much, sometimes you can just clear your history, start a new chat, and then see what it'll come up with. And let's go ahead and see, instead of just putting write a product description, let's see if I do a write an Amazon product description, if that makes any difference. All right, so that's what it came up with. Pretty good. It repeats some of the stuff from the last one, but also rephrases other points. And like I mentioned earlier, what you want to do is you want to be taking what it gives you and not just using it right away. You want to be taking what it gives you, pick out the sentences, the phrasing, the way it uses certain words, and piece it together the way you think is best for your product. So this is still pretty short for an Amazon product description. So you could go ahead, let's see if we can get it to expand on this without doing anything else. I'm just going to say expand on the previous content. Let's see if that works. So that's what it came up with here. Looks like it added, broke it up into a few paragraphs, added some more content. So this is something, again, you just repeat the process over and over until you find, until you're happy with what you come up with. So what do I think? Can you use ChatGPT to write an Amazon listing? Well, I'd say at least at this point in time that you can't use it just exactly what it spits out to write an Amazon listing. There's a lot more that goes into it, especially as far as proper SEO, search engine optimization for Amazon, you really want to make sure you're using the right keyword phrases, the right keywords, individual keywords, et cetera, to make sure that you're showing up as best you can in the search results. And that's something that, as of now at least, this can't do, but maybe in the future it'll be some software or tool that can do that a little bit better. But what I would do is I would take the title ideas, the bullet point ideas, and the product description ideas, and I would take those and I would get it the way I want it, and I'd go through and rewrite certain sections to make sure that I have the exact phrases I want used and I have the exact words I want to use. Another thing you could do is, like I did in the title section, is I asked it to use certain keywords, keyword phrases. You could go ahead and do that as well, for example, when you're writing your product description, when you're writing the bullet points, and see if it'll include include those in there as well. The best part about this is, as of making this video, it is free to use. So don't hesitate to go ahead and just sign up for an account if you want. Go ahead and see what you can come up with it, have some fun with it. You don't even have to use it for Amazon. You can use it for whatever really you can think of, as long as it follows their terms of service. You can have some fun with it, be creative with it. Some other ideas that you could use it for is maybe changing the tone of voice. You could say, you know, write it in a tone that is more salesy, or maybe to make it more convincing, write it in a tone that is more fun or more creative. Write it in a tone that is more cheerful, or whatever you want to throw at it and see what it can come up with. You could also say things like, make this easier to read. Make it easier to understand. You can use it to, you know, break through some writer's block. If you're having this writer's block of what to put in your Amazon listing, this will definitely help with that. You can even use it to help understand your product more and to understand your target customer. Let's see what this comes up with. I asked, what are some of the main things people look for when buying a garlic press? And these are some of the things that came up with: durability, ease of use, comfort, cleaning, design, price. A lot of those are things that I already came up with already. But this could help you if you're in the beginning stages of trying to understand your product more. And let's go and see if this can even say, who is the target market for a garlic press? So it says the target market could be, you know, people who enjoy cooking, could be professional chefs, home cooks, could be people that frequently cook with garlic and want a tool that makes the process quicker and easier. So again, it gives you some ideas. We're only scratching the surface of what we're able to do with this tool, and it's going to be a lot of fun to see what people come up with. If you come up with some good ideas and prompts that you want to share, go ahead and put it in the comments down below. Could be related to Amazon, could be not related to Amazon, but go ahead and put it in the comments, and so other people can see it and try out for themselves. AI is the future, and it's coming rapidly. It's only going to get better and better, but luckily I see it, at least in this use, is going to make our lives as sellers and business owners easier. I hope you enjoyed this. I appreciate a like and a comment on the video if you did. Subscribe if you'd like to see more content like this related to Amazon and e-commerce and business, and I hope to see you in the next video.